Welcome back to MooMooMath. We're going to practice some more completing the square problems. Okay, here we go. We've got x squared minus 4x is equal to 2x plus 35. To complete the square, we want to get all the terms with x's on the same side. So I'm going to move this 2x over to the other side of the equation. So I'm going to have x squared, negative 4x minus 2x is negative 6x, is equal to, and I'm just going to bring down the 35. My constant stays on the right. Now, I'm going to complete the square by taking the b term and halving it and squaring it. So I'm going to take 6, and I'm going to half it and square it, and then I'm going to add it to both sides. So half of 6 is 3. 3 squared is 9. So I'm going to add 9 to the right side, and I'm going to add 9 to the left side because we have to keep an equation balance. So if we add something to one side, we have to add it to the other. Okay, what we've created on the left side is a perfect square. So x squared minus 6x plus 9 factors into x plus 3 times x plus 3, or x plus 3 quantity squared, is equal to, and then 35 plus 9 is 44. Now we're just going to keep going and solve the equation by taking the square root of both sides. And that a square root and a square are opposite operations, so it cancels. So I'm left with x plus 3 is equal to, I've taken the square root of this side, so you have to account for both roots, a positive and a negative. And then the square root of 44 is 4 times 11. And we know that we can bring a 2 out of this because 4 is a perfect square. So 2 root 11. Okay, we still aren't quite done. We haven't solved for x, so let's subtract 3 from both sides. So x is equal to negative 3 plus or minus 2 square root 11. And that's how you complete this, use quadratics and completing the square to solve a quadratic. So let's go down and do one more that has a lead coefficient this time. This time this one is 2x squared minus 12x is equal to, and you can't quite see that's negative 14. Okay, my x terms are both together on the left-hand side, but I have a lead coefficient of 2. So I can't just complete the square. I have to get rid of that 2. So I'm going to divide every term by 2 to get my lead coefficient to be a 1, which is what I need. So I'm going to divide by 2. So x squared minus 12 divided by 2 is 6x is equal to negative 14 divided by 2 is negative 7. Okay, I have my squared terms on the right. My lead coefficient is a 1. So I'm going to half it and square it and add it to both sides. So half of 6 is 3. 3 squared is 9. So I'm going to add a 9 to the left side. If I add a 9 to the left side, I have to add it to the right to keep it a balanced equation. Then this factors into what multiplies to 9 that adds to negative 6. And that's negative 3 times negative 3. So it's x minus 3 quantity squared is equal to positive 2. And then we just proceed with solving by taking the square root. Let's take the square root of both sides. So I'm left with x minus 3 on the left side. On the right, I have to account for both solutions, positive and negative. So I have x minus 3 is equal to plus or minus 2, and add 3. So x is equal to positive 3 plus or minus square root of 2. And that's how you solve by completing the square. Hope this video is helpful.